What's happening, people? It's Bengo and I'm back on UTR TV. Pow!
Lights! Action! Couple more bottles for the man there. Jesse J, do it like the man them.
Yeah, I've been in the studio, I've been in the lab creating this album, and you know, so at certain times, one of the key things to releasing an album is that you got to be happy with it. You got to be excited about it. And so I was in the studio just making sure that I was, you know, completely finished with it. And I knew that once it came, I could be proud of a piece of work. So that's where I've been, just producing that.
Chapter 2,
baby.
Started like some old school prodigy. Take a pop of me, you niggas my protege.
I think one of the key things is that when you get this album, it's a full album, so you can listen to it for an hour and actually sit down and it takes you on a journey. I hate to use that word, it sounds so cliche and so boring, but you know, this album is a good album. I've spent a lot of time on it and I've listened to a lot of albums. Like, I've listened to Rudimental's album, haven't really quite got round to Disclosures yet. But a lot of the people that are, to me, killing it at the moment, I still think my album's the best. So, who knows?
But them man some Pinocchios. I was in the dance rocking academics and brothers.
There's two on there, that's best for festivals. One of them's gonna be Choose One, because if you're at any festivals that I'm playing at and you see me and Young perform that, you're gonna be going crazy for it afterwards. I mean, because his performance is amazing, but what the song is based on is amazing, and the antics that we are gonna be pulling off on stage. Girls are gonna be on stage, that shit's gonna be amazing. Right, full stop. But then the other song for me that's a great festival song is Smile. Have you heard that yet?
Oh yeah, no.
Smile is like,
oh yeah, that's the opposite.
Yeah, you're gonna be going mental, it's like blasting it. Oh really? You're not mad at this guy. He's definitely got the right idea. But yeah, Smile with Charlie XCX is like another festival banger. It's like hands in the air. It's got a great hook, it's really singable. But then it sounds powerful. It's like, I produced it with Dream. And we all know that Dream's got production under his belt, so yeah, it's gonna bang. For chilling on the beach, a couple. I think, again, this is not a one track thing. I'd say number one, there would have to be chilling on the beach, would have to be There's No Soul, which is track 7 on my album. Again, that's the future. That shit's the future. I think it doesn't sound like anything else at the moment. The chords are wonky. It's like, not many people come up with chord patterns like this because they're always afraid to go a bit left. Then I guess another beach tune is going to have to be Higher with Autumn Road. Again, piano stabs, aim and break. Quite aggressive still, but you know, you can sit there and listen on the beach, like in the sun, with your headphones in, having a nice time.
Just trying to live.
Just trying to live, dog! The best tune for the gym is going to have to be Yellow. I'm guessing you've heard that.
I've heard Yellow, yeah.
Yellow's the like intro to my album, and I think that gets you going. Gets the people going. But other tunes for the gym, to Hell and Back. Mm-hmm. That's a banger. That's gonna make you wanna run, make you go crazy, make you get active. Getting 42 on the deluxe version. That's a tune for the gym. That's gonna get you pumped up, gonna get your blood rushing. The tune for Lovemaking on my album, the last tune on there, which is called Waiting. Features happiness. Again, her, Rudy and Daniel Ladinsky, who wrote the track, right, the vocal, it's just proper, it's a love song to me, do you know what I mean? It's one of them that I could just imagine, like, getting down in the bedroom, but, like, you know, not having it, like, getting down.
Love making, not fucking.
In it? Love making, but not fucking. Can I live? Do you know what? To be fair, I don't make that stuff anymore, do I? I just make banger music, which is like future soul and just energy. I call it future soul because the beats are futuristic and the basses are futuristic, but it's still really, really soulful. So I'm just doing my own thing, that's it. I think where I need to be and where I think I will be, not even I think, where I will be, is in a position where I am writing again for the likes of Eve, and I am writing again for the likes of Busta Rhymes or Lil Wayne or Drake. And I think my album is a great product. It's a really good album, but I think it also is a promotional tool in terms of people will listen to the vocals and listen to the style of the music and think, I would like Bengus to do this for my artist. It's kind of like, it puts me in the shopping window again. Do you understand what I mean? So I plan to go back to LA because I did live in LA for a little minute and I was just living in the hills in some pimp crib and just like producing tunes. And I just think I'd love to go back to that again.
A bit different to Croydon.
Yeah. It has been a bit different to Croydon for a minute. I live in Putney. It's like me. Every young child fresh like me. Mike's ever gonna Christmas. Oh, I mean, I remember the first time I played a UTR show. Fire. And that's the time when I played After Scream, right? Yeah, I remember. And I just remember coming in and thinking, fucking hell. Like, it was ram. In terms of vibe, I thought that is amazing. I didn't get things like that when I was a youth. I didn't get to go and see like my favourite. I didn't get to see Shy Effect when I was 15 years old and stuff. And I just think that's amazing. So again, you lot looked out for me, brought me to that audience and made me see that I did have an audience of that at that age and stuff. So for that, big respect and pure love. So I'll tell you what, one thing that I see more energy and a bit more of I don't give a fuck. Like, one of the shows that I played was just Matter, right? And Turn Up Again. And I played Filth. I remember going on thinking, what am I gonna play? And just going in, playing slammer after slammer. And I just thought, it's better than her over 18 dance, you know what I mean? So, yeah. I'd say, and I know this is a bit cliche and probably a bit over said, but it's key. And I would definitely say to be original. And it gets harder and harder because things get oversaturated. And then, you know, I think young people always have mentors and people to aspire to. So they kind of follow a sound. And I think maybe it's good to learn, like to copy other people's music, to learn. But in order to get noticed, you have to sound different. Because what's going to make me listen to 20 tunes and pick one person? Because of the difference, right? Like the first 5 seconds hearing something different, that pricks my ear up and that's it. Originality is key, dog. Pow, the formula to success. You need desire, you need persistence, and you need goals. I have a few material goals. I always had that I wanted to get, like, a Maserati, and I wanted to get a house like my mum's, and all these type of things that I had material-wise. I had these things that I was constantly going at in my head, and like, you know, I wanted to achieve this, and sometimes I wanted to achieve like arenas, I wanted to play in arenas, I wanted to play stadiums and stuff, and I still haven't really reached stadiums yet, but it's a big goal, and you've got to dream that, and then continue to persevere in it. I think you should really go and check out my album. It's different, it's creative, and it's definitely energetic. So, you know, if you want to go crazy, or if you just want to sit down and have a listen in your house, go grab that, go cop that, and you're going to see me very soon at some UTR events. Promise. Big up. So I've got 2 signed copies of my album here. We're going to be giving these away very shortly on Facebook, on Twitter. So keep an eye out for these. They are signed with gold pen. Cannot be mad at me.
Chapter 2.
Goose, I raved to the death, brother, thinking the papers. I'm able to spend when you think of the hate, and you may want to say, nigga, do me a